हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ लेक्चरर मिस अदिति अनिल कुशारे, मास्टर ऑफ फार्मेसी इन क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस टेक्निक्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक फर्स्ट एड फॉर शॉक फ्रॉम हेल्थ एजुकेशन एंड कम्युनिटी फार्मेसी। द फर्स्ट एड फॉर शॉक, द टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड आर एज फॉलोज, डेफिनेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट एड एंड फर्स्ट एड ऑफ शॉक। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स सी अबाउट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फर्स्ट एड। First aid is the provision of immediate care to a victim with an injury or illness, usually affected by a lay person and performed within a limited skill range. Then the first aid is normally performed until the injury or illness is satisfactorily dealt with, such as in the case of small cuts, minor bruises and the blisters, or until the next level of care, such as a paramedic or doctor arrives. Then first aid is an emergency aid or treatment given to someone injured, suddenly ill, etc. before regular medical services arrive or can be reached. Then let's see about the shock and first aid treatment, or what should be done for as a first aid for shock. Let's see first of all definition of shock. Poor circulation to the vital organs, shock is very serious and life-threatening. The casualty may not know that they are in shock. Then let's see about the causes of shock. Dilated blood vessels, bleeding, severe dehydration, all leading to a drop in a blood pressure which results in poor circulation. These can be caused by severe emotional trauma, physical injury, illness, etc. Then let's see about the signs and symptoms of shock. These are important for identifying the shock. Unusual behavior, for an example, very calm or very anxiousness. Then lack of pain to an injury. Rapid breathing, rapid but weak pulse, bluish skin, that is called as a cyanosis, and unconsciousness. Then let's see about management for shock. Activate the ambulance in a right way and assist the person to lie on their side to improve the circulation. Treat any injuries. It will help them take any medication for an illness. So this management is called as a first aid treatment for shock. The position of the person who is getting shocked, then after getting shocked, the person should be lying down in this way. We can see the body posture in this figure. The person is first lying down. So, as we know, the blood circulation is from the top to bottom, and if the person is lying down, then the conduction of that particular shock will not going to hamper the situation of the person, or it does not make the situation worsen. Then the first aid shock, the learning outcomes from this session are definition of first aid and the first aid of shock. Thank you.